greetings to you all. My name is the Professor and welcome to the first episode of The Utter Nonsense, a show dedicated to the knowledgeable endeavors of discussing numerous topics of intellectual interest and sociable commentary, a program devoted to the academic pursuit of cultural, economical, and religious understanding. Today's discussion: why the flying fuck is every goddamn movie trailer nowadays claiming that their film is the number one movie of the year? Seriously. What the fuck? Since the dawn of mankind, the television set has been broadcasting high-grade visual stimuli throughout the centuries. Hours upon hours of pure sweet mind candy for the daily masses. From state-of-the-art commercials to a slew of entertainment and original programming, the television set has found itself a place within history. A conglomerate mogul of media enlightenment. Some anthropologists even theorize the television set can be carbon dated all the way back to prehistoric periods, claiming that dinosaurs were the first to invent reality television.
Last week on the Bad Jurassic Club.
Le verrou de la porte! Ellie, commande le verrouillage de la porte!
Well, as you can see, not every reality show spin-off is a complete success. But for the modern-day consumer on the go, the television set transmits mental uploads such as essential products necessary for daily functioning.
And what did he get? What?
Hi, it's Vince with ShamWow.
A constant flow of original and fresh new entertainment.
And most important of all, movie trailer television ads.
They're back.
Welcome back, everyone. Now that I got your attention again, I bet you kids are asking yourself right now, how are movie trailer television commercial spots made? Oh, Grand Professor Man. Well, you see, it all begins far, far away in a distant land known as...
Yes. Hollywood. A magical land of sexy opportunities, extravagant lifestyles, and home of the original sex scandal. Hidden away in a secret underground laboratory, Hollywood fun engineers work daily to cram the best parts of movies into brief digital light shows. Henceforth, a trailer is born. But once a trailer grows big and strong, it heads off to theater school, experiments with drugs, does a few art films, falls in with the wrong crowd, ends up on the street, finally makes it to the big screen, becomes addicted to Fundia, tries to get its soul back, then hits rock bottom.
So by the time a movie trailer is broadcasted on the telly, it has no other place else to go.
Any more questions?
Hi. 私はそんなことには一切興味がない。あれこれ改革して問題が解決するような、もはやそんな甘っちょろい段階にはない。こんな国はもう見捨てるしかないんだ。こんな国はもう滅ぼせ。私にはそのシステムを支えてきたのは諸君に他ならないからだ。正確に言えば諸君の中の少数派に呼びかけている。その話は長くなるから。多数派が勝つに決まってるじゃないか。じゃあどうして立候補してんのか。掲示板のポスターを見てくれ。
Get on with it!
Oh, come on now. I am sick and tired of all these interruptions, you bloody wankers. You can take this job and shove. Flying monkeys coming out of your mum's vagina. And Tom Selleck's mustache. I guess the moral of today's episode is, no matter how good a movie trailer appears, be wary. Because by the time you make it to the movie theater, you end up paying to watch a steaming pile of dog shit on the big screen. Well, I hope you enjoyed this intellectual inebriation of the frontal lobe region. Tune in next time when we discuss the important issue of zombies. And remember, I wear the cheese doesn't wear me. Good night, everyone.
It was a night like this, 40 million years ago. I lit a cigarette, picked up a monkey's glove to go. The sun was spitting fire, the sky was blue and lights. I felt a little tight, so I watched Miami Vice. I walked the dinosaur. I walked the dinosaur.
Fuck.